Oh, I hope we can win this game.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
But only by a point.
I'm Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. This NBA season rocking right along, and we're loving every minute of it. In this game, we'll see the Oklahoma City Thunder against the Dallas Mavericks. For Dallas, they're keeping pace with their win total from last season, holding steady, though they'd like to move the needle and continue to improve. And tip-off approaching, but in the meantime, let's discuss post-play. Shaq, you were a dominant post-scorer, duh. Who do you think are the top post scorers in the NBA right
DeMarcus
now?
DeMarcus Cousins, 25-13. You know, can go inside and go outside. He's a little frantic at times, but he's up there. Zach Randolph, he's got great feet work, nice soft touch.
Feet
Big
work.
Al Jefferson, a.k.a. Baby Fundamentals. He does everything with his right hand, so
BF.
He's so good, that's all he needs. And Brooke Lopez, nice size, nice touch. And nice feet work, too. I know you say feet work is not a word, but you can't do nothing with footwork. You need both feet. So, Dr. O'Neal, name it feet work. Put it in the dictionary. Shut it up.
Okay. Well, you know what? The guy who reminds me of Shaq a little bit, Nikola. Yes.
Stop it.
He does, man. He's got some
of your mind.
He overpowers guys.
Stop it.
I mean, it's like a little version
Cut
of
it out.
Which, okay, all right.
Send it to Kevin for a body slam this guy.
I was reaching, man. I had the Kevin Durant arms on that. I was reaching.
All right.
Oh, Tim Dwight Duncan's Howard, Blake Griffin, good guys. That overpower people. We're talking about.
Okay, my bad. I apologize.
Just overpowering.
No, but I already said the top centers in the league.
I'm just saying about overpowering.
Answer the question, man.
Okay, my bad.
Time to go down to Kevin Harlan. He's got the call, Kevin.
Nikola!
Thunderstorms come with the territory here in the Sooner State. Oklahoma City, land of the Thunder, in a fine Western Conference battle here at the Chesapeake Energy Arena. Welcome to what should be a great Saturday night for the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan to call the game with our
analyst, Clark Kellogg, and Greg Anthony.
And of course, Freak. Coaches really like the improvement he's made in practice from day one tonight.
Okay, good. And shooting
Dallas
guard again.
By five. On the floor for Dallas, we've got Chandler Parsons. J.J. Barea is out there
okay,
with McCollum.
Now I know what they
and there's Anderson.
Do.
And McCollum throws it down hard.
I really don't need to see that again.
Rubs it in. It looks like a little deeper with the hanging finish.
I tell you what, they're not backing off at all, are they?
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slam Cam. Oklahoma City's going over
on this camera
three point land. Nothing yet going outside. They set the pick. Durant drawing the double team. Adams
Come
outside.
On. Finally,
out to the wing.
Pick.
Here's Peters. Money from the wing.
Yes, that was a nice
Freak's got his
shot.
First basket of the night. For so long, Clark, Freak has made it apparent that he wants to be a global star. Isn't that what all these guys really want? And tries to achieve that through endorsements. You wonder if he has taken some of his focus off the game.
Well, you know, it's perfectly fine
he's
for
always
an NBA player to sign a few endorsements, but you have to make sure that the main thing stays the main thing. NBA players need to hoop more than they need to worry about their brand.
The Mavericks shooting their first free throws of this game. The free throw drops.
Yeah, I gotta go to practice.
Different look for Oklahoma City. McGarry's checked in for Ibaka.
For
and Anthony
team.
Morrow subbed in for Russell Westbrook. That misses, so he splits the free throws.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Durant and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Yes.
Well, defense is a big part of these players' games. The
nice, now we get those points back.
This season, Kevin Durant is second.
And that's a group of perhaps
the
most
well-rounded
defenders in our league. Solid on the perimeter with the ability to block shots on the interior.
Yeah, they really do make up the perfect blueprint of a strong defender at the three spot. Combining
Can we
the
hurry?
Ability to defend on the floor and in the air.
And
first free throw is good.
He made
Jeremy
it.
Evans checks in for Parsons.
Come on, man.
And he can't hit the second.
And he missed that one.
Mavericks leading by five. Now let's send it down to Doris Burke, who is able to talk with Byron Scott.
Yes.
Kevin, you told me that basically on the defensive end, if they can do a good job on their outside shooters, everything else should fall
past
into
assist.
Place. He said, listen, if we can force them to work the ball inside on a consistent basis, we feel like we have an excellent chance to win.
Well,
we'll see,
got my grade
Thank
up.
Thank you, Doris. Devising a strategy, Clark, to take away that three-point shot.
Yeah, I think it's an important part of your defensive game plan because teams nowadays are just too good
to
not defend
that.
Them from behind the three-point. Line.
A nice shot by Anderson.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just
inviting
trouble.
Oh, I forgot I was moved to point guard.
Here's Freak. He averages more than 12 points a game. That's some dependable production. And Durant gets double teamed. Here's Adams. And he gets it to go.
Andor.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
And he's got his
Let's
first chance at the line here.
Yes, he made it.
Well, it was the Oklahoma City Thunder winning their last game against Sacramento.
And Kevin, you know, they showed how important it is to have
Wasn't
a strong
Wasn't it just
bench.
Like by
I mean,
one
when
point?
When you are on the road, that depth is vital. I think they really utilized the second unit to extend their offensive assault and just really
Defensive
wore
breakdown.
Down their opponent.
I
was
and guys, I think
it.
What you saw from them throughout the game was teamwork. This is a team. Regardless of who was out there on the floor at any given time, they got it done.
Yes, pass lead
that has to
foul.
Make you feel good as a group. Looking at the Mavericks over the last 10 games, Kevin, this is how they compare to the rest of the league. Second in three-point field goal percentage, fourth in steals. And they also show up in the top five in free throw shooting. That's elite level marksmanship at the stripe.
You know, you go back to their three-point field goal percentage, some true dead eyes on their roster, no doubt. And that's such a luxury offensively. They have been absolutely lights out.
That was well said. He knows what he's talking about.
All right, now, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Yeah, we know what to do.
No good on that one. And the second free throw, good.
At least he made that one.
Mavericks leading by four. Now, here's Barea. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points
a
game.
That would have been a turnover.
From 11 feet away,
I was right in his
here's
face.
Evans. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Evans has got his first basket.
And the defense just gets caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass.
Aw, really?
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Here's measuring.
Always
so the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And a moment now to check out the numbers for Freak. How's the last month of basketball been for him? He's putting up 13 points a game, two assists, and two rebounds. And when he takes over at the point, he really keeps the offense flowing.
Well, his skill set is solid. He's a good ball handler. He makes good decisions in playmaking. He's really the ideal backup.
Aw, thanks. Except for the backup part.
And he can't get the first one.
Absolutely stone cold at the line thus far.
And they need every point they can muster right now. They've got to cash in here.
I never really got the OKC mascot.
Down low.
I never really the rim with a two-handed
slam. Wow. And if that doesn't get them fired up, guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Tell you what, fellas, that could give them the energy boost they've been looking for.
Barea kicks to McCullough. Wide open.
He is.
And Barea with the basket
that.
On the assist by McCollum. So for Dallas, their last game a loss to the Kings. Here's Peters. Gets the front of the rim and out.
That's not a sight you see very often.
I was trying to do a pump fake.
He has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
They set the pick. 1:51 left to play here in the first. To the inside, McGarry with the steal.
Pass me the ball there.
Here we go. Freak heading to the hoop. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Sometimes when you want something done, you got to do it yourself. That dunks the shot in the arm they need to really cut
into that. He never does the
windmills.
It's certainly got everybody on their bench up and off their seats.
Because I have
and cheering.
The windmill
clip
for him.
Yeah, that could be an instant momentum shift. That certainly was a rim record.
The Mavericks shooting their fifth
and
sixth free throws
of
the game.
And as a unit, they're shooting 78% from the line. That's a solid number to work with on the season.
Really, guys, it's just come together for them at the charity stripe this season. I mean, the confidence is there, and so too are the results.
And the Mavericks making a change here. Harris has checked in. He hits one and misses one, each at the line.
And the missed opportunities for them at the line here early on.
And those can often come back to haunt you, Greg.
Good thing he was right there.
And really make the most of the chances.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse.
Defensive breakdown. Surprise,
nice work
surprise.
On the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not
like
supposed
that.
To be easy down there. And a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
Anderson against Durant.
Come on, Durant.
Shot clock at 5. Got it. Good job in the low post.
Oh, wow, that was a nice shot.
And that's just taking advantage of some soft defense on that drive. Little resistance for him on the way to the basket.
Ball's knocked loose.
Forced turnover. Ooh.
Adams dishes to Morrow.
Of course I would get a loose ball right after.
Freak kicks to Morrow. We've got 22 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Here's Adams. Score the basket. His
oh, I thought it was
attempts.
About to move out.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
To the middle, to the inside. Evans passes to McCollum.
They're not going to pass it to him.
Tries from 10. The basket good off the assist from Evans. McCollum's got 5. And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. And Kevin Durant always in the gym, always working to improve. We asked him where that
comes from, me being 8 years old and me just saying I wanted to be the best player. You know, first off, at 8 years old, you want to be the best player in your neighborhood. And that's where it comes from, just always wanting to be the best and no matter where I'm playing at. And if I keep working each and every year, I've gotten better. You know, if I continue to just keep working, I've seen improvements.
Year by year improvements until he became the best player in the league and won an MVP. Now, the challenge, Greg, is to get back to that level after the injuries. Obviously, I think we all feel it is possible for him.
And you're absolutely right, Kevin. I mean, he's definitely
Steph Curry's like one of the best players.
Dallas has gone 2 of 4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. Williams dishes to McCollum.
Oh, you know how to shoot from the three-point.
That's good, and he's now
3 for 4
from the field.
Down.
How about the way he's able to angle
Man,
his
I
body
must have
to
been
shield the
shooting
off
guard
and still get the finish?
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. And He made it made it look easy that time.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
Outside Anderson.
Who do they want me to guard?
Outside Williams, six to shoot. The kick out to Anderson. Fires for three. A Thunder ball.
Yes.
Clear look at the hoop. Who doesn't miss many of those?
Okay, yeah.
Oklahoma City moving the ball around. McGarry. And they had their chances.
He
two
really should have just passed
the
ball.
But they still come up empty. Williams with the ball. Now guarded by Payne. A three from Anderson. It's good. Great play by Williams to set it up. Williams has got three assists tonight. Rebound.
And he found the perfect spot behind the arc there. Big gap in the deep.
And here's Payne looking for his first basket still in this one. Freak sets a screen for Durant. Let's it go from 14. And he can't bank that one
usually
in.
He can bank those type of
shots from 3-point range to go down in the second quarter. 3 of 6 from downtown.
Who knows, maybe he should have just
Anderson
passed it.
Can't get it to go.
That's a shot he's gotta hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Come on, man, take the screen.
Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. And it's out of bounds, and they say it was last touched by Durant. And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, Kev, Freak, in the last matchup against the Kings, made some nice plays. He finished with 8 points, and he also added a few assists.
Oh, I
as
know.
He set up his teammates as well. It was a great contribution from someone who is considered a bit more of a role player on his team.
Thanks, Doris. He had a heck of an outing that night, GA.
Yeah, he really did, Kevin. I mean, a very professional performance. Played hard every single second he was on the court.
Guys, that's what we expect
and we have
from him,
to get
and
those
he rarely
rebounds.
Lets us down, and he certainly didn't let us down that night.
Payne kicks to McGarry. Peters passes to McGarry.
I'm not open.
It to Payne. There's a good screen. Plays it up and banks it in.
Yes, that was my
Payne's
shot.
Payne's got his first 2 points.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders
good
with
shot,
the way they
shot
work
selection.
Down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points in the paint. And one thing I liked in the first quarter was their aggressiveness
tried to help
draw
them on
the contact, putting the defense on the defense.
And bad shot.
Yeah,
shot
exactly. And I think they need to continue to press that advantage.
Since
got to
the
get
quality
back to that.
Was
Don't go
a
away
D
from
plus.
That. It's been working so well for them. Stay with us.
Outside Williams, Nowitzki for three. Again, the miss
and
by Nowitzki.
And I get the rebound.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I'm about as shocked as you are, Clark.
Durant with the wide
Come
open
on,
look.
Man.
He nailed
yes.
it, and we're tied up. Durant's got 4 points in the quarter.
Pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Williams with the ball. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Kings in Sacramento. Here's Nowitzki. And a big
Man.
Bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Nowitzki's got 12 in the game.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
To the wing on the left.
They're only up by like 2 points.
Gary dishes to Durant. Stolen by Anderson. 7-second difference. Shot and game clock. Out to the right wing. A three from McCollum. Another field goal for him.
I don't know why he tried to block that.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
Thunder trailing by 5.
Where is Westbrook? Is that guy hurt?
Here's the screen. Inside, Adams, the pass to McGarry. And Adams with the
that's
slam.
And that's how it's played. I mean, find that hole in the deep and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was.
He just jumped up in the air and caught it. Let's see what Coach has to say.
At the defensive end than that.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Mavericks lead by 3. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Kevin, obviously a very close game. What has been your approach tonight?
Well, we're just trying to pack the paint. Those guys are great. So we're just trying to make them see a few guys, get some deflections, and get some easy baskets.
Kevin, thank you so much. A hardworking Kevin Durant, gentlemen.
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be right back after halftime for the start of quarter number three.
Okay, guys, we got a few minutes here. Let's go over a few things before we get going again. First things first, how about the job we've done in the paint offensively? It was men against boys down there. We've had our way with them. Our focus has to be operating as much as possible from the low block. But we did get a nice lift off the bench in that half. I might want to stay with some of those hot hands, so everybody be ready. And just to talk about what we want for the pace of the game, I'd say nice and steady suits us just fine. It doesn't have to be a track meet. And that's all I wanted to go over with you. Let's go play a good half of basketball.
That was like the shortest speech he ever did.
Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far.
A lot of action from Nowitzki. 12 points. He's done a little bit of work behind the arc. He's got a pair of three-pointers.
And you know what? The defenders have that in the back of their minds now. They'll be on him a little tighter.
Well, yeah. Sounds very. I can't exactly think of a word for it. Oh, that was so good. Let's see if I touch the floor.
Thunder trailing by three. Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled
up. Yeah,
I'm
not about to watch that. Glitch. Pressing the random buttons is not gonna work every time. Finally, I got it.
Well, it was the Dallas Mavericks in their last game of loss to the Kings in Sacramento. Left side, Westbrook. To tie. He shoots
again. Maybe he should have just passed it.
All even. Adams has got 10.
I wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
And, Greg, it's clearly been their edge, and in a close game like this, you look for every edge you can find.
I didn't get to read about you because the game broke.
Here's Barea. He's got 9. 6 on the shot clock. To the paint, Anderson. So the whistle blows on the shot. And 2 free throws for the contact right there. Well, folks, tonight a great rebounding game we're watching in progress. And now, you know, with that in mind, let's take a look at the all-time record for rebounds in a single game. How about Wilt Chamberlain with 55 rebounds back on November 24th, 1960.
And guys, that's one of those records that always seemed to me impossible to break. I mean, in the modern era, nobody's even sniffed that 55 rebound mark. I mean, heck, a lot of teams don't get 55 rebounds in a game, and Wilt's owned it since 1960.
All right, now, gentlemen, two shots. Loop shots.
I know how this works.
And the first one drops. CJ McCollum, he's checked in for Dallas. Both free throws good from Anderson.
Finally, now let's hurry up.
Here's Westbrook. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. And it's Westbrook again missing.
He should have passed it.
McCollum with the ball. Out defended by Freak. Now here's Barea. He's guarded closely.
We should get a foul.
Evans. Shot misses. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. And this matchup with Dallas, it's their first meeting of the season.
And even though they were the better team overall, they actually lost the season series against the club a year ago. Anyway.
Yeah, and for them, that was a bit embarrassing. So expect them to come back with a
point. Oh, I thought that was
tonight.
A turnover.
And here are the Mavericks now. Anderson outside.
He
kicks
screen.
It to McCollum. Dishes to Barea.
How many screens are going to set?
The shot. Yes, it is. Scored that as a bucket. Number 5 on a 5 for 11 night. Oklahoma City has gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime.
Just casually walking.
Outside Westbrook. Looking to get back on track here. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
Oh, that was a nice spell.
It's working beautifully.
It really is. 5 out of 6 of their last field goals have come from the paint.
Mitch McGarry's checked in for Serge Ibaka. And Dallas with a change here, too. Chandler Parsons, he's checked in for Jeremy Evans. The Thunder have gone 7 of 11 from the line.
You've got to appreciate their ability to make free throws, 81% as a team.
And they've made progress in that department from last season going into this one, guys. I mean, the numbers have improved.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
Yeah, really left them no choice there, Greg. He had to foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
For
and
Oklahoma City, they had made a little more than half the
free
throws
rating
today.
Is a 90.
Dane, he's checked in for Oklahoma City.
So I sure make all my shots.
And both free throws good from Freak.
He has such terrific form and consistency on his free throw. Beautiful to watch.
Anderson outside.
Oh, wow, thanks.
They set the pick. Feeds it to McCollum.
I'm right next
Here's
to you.
Here's Barea. Another miss by Barea.
Well, he had 1 3-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
Out left to the wing. Here's Peters.
He wasn't right there. Really? Here's it was
McGarry.
A B-minus.
And
come
the bucket
on.
Counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
You're right, Clark. Just continue to pound it in the paint and get those easy points inside.
Dirk Nowitzki, he's checked in for Chandler Parsons. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Thunder.
They've knocked down plenty of mid-range jumpers in this one. That's been big for them.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end.
Now, here's Barea.
If you stop moving so much.
To end the run, and the jumper is good. 14 points for Dirk Nowitzki.
Yeah, it's just a smart shot, taking advantage of the
mismatch.
Well, with a stroke like that and the height advantage as well, mid-range J is almost a gimme.
Now, here's Payne, guarded by Barea. Offensive rebound, Adams, and the dunk to finish
that was
it off.
A nice rebound.
And gobbled up that rebound and went straight into attack mode on the putback.
Oof, he is one of the most determined rebounders, Clark, we have got in the NBA.
Yeah, you're calling it right, Kevin. I mean, he gets so many second chance points because of how hard he works to get to the rebound.
Here's Peters, and
that was a nice play.
Rubs it in. It looks like a little deeper with the hanging finish.
I tell you what, they're not backing off at all, are they?
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
The story in the first half was their low free
throw. Oh, he only has two fouls.
They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
The Mavericks have made 8 of their 12 free throws in this game. A free throw drops for Dirk Nowitzki, and the Thunder making a switch here. Durant's checked in.
Come on.
That one is no good.
You know, they've been outstanding on the boards, and it's a big reason why they've got a lead. Doing the dirty work down low.
We call that a collabo because everybody's boxing out and making sure they
That's like three guys on me.
No good. Now the Mavericks take it the other
way. And I was really hoping
One, they get to host the Pelicans. That game is the first and last of their homestand. We've got 1:13 left in the third. Six to shoot. Kicks to Nowitzki. Takes it from 10, and Durant sends it back.
Yes, good job, Durant.
Morrow, that's a two-pointer. That's good, and a nice assist from Durant. Durant's got 5 assists tonight.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
There's the pick. Barea kicks to Nowitzki. To the paint. Here's McCollum. Great pass to set
right
up the lay-in.
Oh, right next to the guy.
McCollum's got 12 points in the game.
The defense has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
And I'd be interested to know just how many of these attempts have come from inside of 5 feet.
And Adams
Nobody, guys, among the defenders stepping up to challenge him on that drive to the 10.
And Greg, he says, thank you very much, and sails in for the flush.
And those are the kind of sequences that tell you why the score is what it is.
That's patiently waiting.
Nowitzki a screen. Here's Barea. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in.
Come on, we still have points in the game.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
11 feet away. No good there. The third quarter comes to a close. It's the Thunder up 6. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports.
There's a highlight for please. Russell Westbrook or Kevin Durant is probably going to be the player of the game.
Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. Checked in for Russell Westbrook C.J. McCollum, he's checked in for Chandler Parsons.
Just like
and
last game.
Is subbed in for Wesley Matthews.
Come on, man. Oh, was I subbed in that point guard?
A minute 42 left to play here in the fourth. On the perimeter, it's Waiters and Durant. Inside, you've got Ibaka and Cantor, and it's Peters in at the
good point. Defense.
That's the lineup in the game for Oklahoma City. Lots of room.
Come on.
That's
yes.
A nice assist from Durant. Durant's got his 8th assist in the game. Mavericks trail by 4. A minute 20 left here in the fourth quarter. That's Nowitzki at the elbow.
Yes, all I needed was just one little score to get a pipe.
Rebounded by Serge Ibaka.
And he's really trying to get them back into it, but the results just have not been there.
Waiters against Nowitzki. Waiters
Come
dishes
on,
to Cantor. no good. Some solid D from Nowitzki.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Count it! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Here's Peters.
Yes, draw foul.
Drew contact on the shot.
It's been a good one for Freak. He's got 10 points, and he's picked up one dime.
And that's so
don't underestimate how important he's been.
And this is what we see when we talk about potential. He's tapped into it today.
Does that mean that you're going to make me player of the game?
For good, and it's a three-point game. Now here's Williams, covered by Peters.
There was just good enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
Waiters passes to Cantor. Yes!
Yes!
And if you thought this game
so
was over already, you're probably right.
Yeah, I would agree. I mean, it's staring us right in the face, and we've been around long enough to know.
Come on,
the game
okay,
is
yep.
Over.
I knew they were going to start doing
that.
Category.
Boy, he quieted the crowd with that big shot. That's a big play.
Ouch, that was a punch.
I hope they know that it makes my free throws.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last
seconds
away.
Early.
No, you got a foul. I mean, it's going to come down to free throws.
I made
here.
It. So
foul
sorry.
Right away.
And so
yes.
Both free throws are good. And it's a five-point game.
Two possession game now. I mean, those were really important
there.
Foul shots.
We're seeing the red hot version of Deron Williams.
Okay,
right now.
Yeah, this isn't good.
Here is Durant, and the call will be against Chandler Parsons. And so he's picked up his final foul.
Come on,
he
man.
Will sit for the rest of this game.
Yes, no good job, Durant.
The foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
But there was no time.
Yes,
really
they
to
don't.
Be selective.
They can't
stopping
win now.
The clock was the priority.
Those free throws are the nail in the coffin, guys.
Pass to Blatch. In the corner, it's Harris. Durant with some nice D. So a close game sees Oklahoma City taking this one. It was
yes.
a fantastic
oh,
ball
you.
Game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, and they got pushed down the stretch, but they did what they
way
needed
play,
to
boy.
Do
way
and
way
held
play.
Their ground when it mattered most.
Hey.
Got the W.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Kevin, this game, a tight one and perhaps a little bit more closely contested than people expected. Was this the sort of game that you were anticipating?
Well, everybody's going to bring their best against us. And we just try to come out here and play hard every possession. We had some mishaps, some slip-ups, but I think did a good job of bouncing back.
Kevin, thank you so much. Guys, always a challenge in the NBA. Back to you at the table.
All right, Doris, thank you. And that about wraps it up. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. Now we'll go to the studio with the award-winning Ernie Johnson.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present to you our Jordan player of the game, Kevin Durant. He had a double-double and made a huge difference tonight. He never let up, and his performance really inspired the rest of his team. What'd you notice about his performance, Kenny?
This was vintage Kevin Durant we saw tonight, fellas. Just tearing it up. He's got the most diverse set of skills out there from an offensive standpoint. There isn't anything he can't do. And defensively, he can do it as well. It's almost impossible to count all the ways Kevin Durant helps his team.
I don't know if there's a fan base that loves their star more than this crowd. Wow, I'm getting jealous. And he feeds off that support. Once they got behind him, he became unstoppable, man.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you enjoyed the show. From myself, Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, have a wonderful evening.
I knew it was going to be Kevin Durant. Four rebounds, 1 assist. And 18 minutes.
Was this game a little too close for comfort?
Well, you never want games to be that close if you can help it. But the important thing here is that we came out with a W. Sure, we didn't execute exactly the way we wanted to, but we got it done in the end. And that's all that matters to me.
Are you getting the ball as much as you'd like out there?
I'm just gonna play the nice guy.
That kind of thing doesn't matter to me. As long as we're winning games, care how much I have the ball in my hands. I really don't. The team comes first. You know that.
But no.
Word is spreading that you're causing some real drama with your off-court commitments. Missing appearances, failing to fulfill contracts. Do you have anything to say about that?
Look, if you want to talk about my business dealings, you have to get in touch with my agent, Don Pagnotti. But you know what? Let me save you the time, because here's what he'll say. No comment. It's silly to comment on stuff like that has no bearing on anything else. So please, let's keep questions on the subject of basketball and basketball only. Thank you.
He said it all smart, too. Nice save.